Chicago has been named one of the four finalists to host the 2016 Olympics. And we're here at a celebration in Daley Plaza to celebrate that nomination.
I want to thank all the citizens, all the religious leaders, all the elected officials, our aldermen, Congressman Emanuel, all the wonderful business community, ethnic community, and of course our guest, Senator Barack Obama. Also introduce Valerie Jarrett, another co-chair of the 2016 Olympics, and also co-chair of a major campaign, Senator Barack Obama's. We have Gary Chico, President of the Chicago Park District, and of course, Maggie Daley, First Lady of Chicago. We are celebrating two wonderful events. Our sister city celebration. What Chicago represents is a history of immigrants, our past, our present, and the future. That has always been the strength of this city and this country, has been immigrants. They have come here from around the world expecting a better way of life. And yes, America has proved a better way of life for immigrants into our country. As we celebrate the sister cities, we're truly celebrating your parents and grandparents and great-great-grandparents that arrived here many, many years ago. And being in Athens this week and meeting so many Greek citizens that have so many relatives in Chicago, that every place that I went to, I was very proud of speaking about Chicago. Because what Chicago represents, a city of great history, our past of immigrants, and especially our future, we have changed the city. We continually change the city for the betterment of our wonderful citizens. In this process, the process of bidding for the 2016 Olympic and Paralympic Games truly represents all the athletes, the Olympic and Paralympic athletes that are behind me, and many will be speaking very shortly. That is the commitment that we have made. When someone asked me, are you going to the Olympics in Beijing? I said yes, because if it wasn't for the Olympics, history would never have known Jesse Owens and Ralph Metcalf in the 1930s. Young African-American men that went, boys, that went over there to compete in Germany. Now think of that. That would never have been a part of world history, the Olympic history, in the history of the United States and Chicago. And that's why the Olympic movement is about athletes. It's about Paralympics. It's all about them training, sacrificing time and energy in order to represent this great country. And that's what this is all about. And I would say to you, I want to thank all those that have participated in this Olympic movement for Chicago in the United States of America, the citizens, the business community, the elected officials that are here, and many more that have worked on behalf of the bid process. We face tough competition, and I know with a person on this platform understands tough competition as well, because we can... We have competition in Madrid, Rio de Janeiro, and Tokyo, well-respected global cities. But I think what we have here is basically a spirit about the Olympic movement, a spirit about Chicago, a spirit about United States of America. This is a great country. We know we have problems, but I will tell you, when you travel throughout the world, you come back and say, God bless America. And what we have in America is something unique, very, very diverse. very diverse, that no other country can talk about diversity as the way as America. That is truly our strength in this country, in our city. And the Olympic movement gives us great opportunities in Chicago. Great opportunities for a global city. Great opportunities for people in regards to jobs and economic development. And the idea, the spirit of all working together with the Olympic and Paralympic movement. To me, I ask all of you to talk to your neighbors and friends to volunteer. Every ethnic community that is here in Chicago will reach out to the ethnic communities all around the world and ask them to understand what Chicago's bid about. It's a bid process that we talk about immigrants, our past, our present, and our future. And this city is a city of change. And we want the Olympians and Paralympians to come here to see the great city of Chicago and see the great country of America. I have the great opportunity of someone who understands maybe more than anyone else, who has traveled all throughout this country, every major city, rural area, suburban, collar county, it doesn't matter. He has seen what many people don't see, the great strength of people of America. And yes, that is our Senator Barack Obama. As he will be leading this country very shortly, with your help, you are the ones that made a difference and will make a difference for this country about the spirit of the Olympic and Paralympic movement, about bringing the best out in this country. And yes, it's a great honor to introduce our Senator Barack Obama.
How's it going, Chicago? It's a good time to be in Chicago. White Sox are winning. Cubs are winning. And Chicago is going to win the 2016 Olympics and Paralympics. And your senator, he's winning too. I am going to be very brief. This was an unscheduled event, but I wanted to come by because Mayor Daley, Maggie Daley, Pat Ryan, the Chicago Olympic Committee, Valerie Jarrett, all the people that have helped to put this bid together have performed an extraordinary service. Because what they've recognized is that bringing the Olympics to Chicago will be a capstone of the success that we've had over the last couple of decades in transforming Chicago to become not just a great American city, but a great world city. Not just a city that works, but a city that inspires, a city that is creative, a city that is about change, a city that's about the 21st century, a city that reflects the diversity that is the strength of America. A city that recognizes that although we come together from different walks of life, different paths, we've got different stories, we've got different histories, that ultimately we share the common values and common ideals of hard work and excellence and determination and a belief in each other, that we have obligations to each other, that we come together and we can accomplish great things that we can't accomplish individually. And it is that same spirit that the Olympics are all about. So I just want you to know, in the interest of full disclosure, I only live two blocks away from where
the Olympics are going to kick off in 2016. And so I'm just going to be able to walk over there. I might have to rent out my house. I don't know how much it's going to be worth. And I also, in the interest of full disclosure, have to let you know that in 2016, I'll be wrapping up my second term as president. So I can't think of a better way than to be marching into Washington Park alongside Mayor Daley, alongside Rahm Emanuel, alongside Dick Durbin, alongside Valerie Jarrett, as President of the United States, and announcing to the world, let the games begin!
Thank you, Senator Obama. We will mark our calendars for Election Day in November, but we'd also like to ask you to stick around for a few moments because we know you're on a tight schedule. One of the things that changes now that we're one of the four finalists for the 2016 Games is we get a new logo. Something to tell the world that, yes, we want the Games here in Chicago. So we'd like to ask all of our guests on stage to go to one of the side patterns here and join us as we unveil that new logo as we go head-to-head against Madrid, Tokyo, and Rio de Janeiro. Two important words on there that say Candidate City. That's the part that says we are now part of the four finalists. Our next speaker is a leader in the House of Representatives, where he is a very strong and effective voice for Chicago. His lifelong commitment to our city is matched only by his Olympic-sized enthusiasm and dedication for the great people of Chicago. Please welcome Congressman Rahm Emanuel.
Welcome. Hope you dry.
Folks, I want you to know that was the mayor when he's not too excited when he was given that speech. We had decaf this morning for him. We're going to be real quick. We all know Chicago is a city of big shoulders. We're about to show the world what the city of big shoulders can do. Second, the mayor said this, I want to underscore it. This is takes a world vote. Call your family around the world. It's time to call your parents. Tell them to vote for Chicago, because it takes 61 votes to do this. Time to call home, because Chicago is going to be the home in 2016. Let's go, Chicago.
Thank you, Congressman. Now, you might hear Mayor Daley talk a lot about Chicago's civic-minded business community. That is one of the secrets to our city's success. Here in Chicago, we get things done thanks to the business and community leaders that are with us today. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the CEO of the Habitat Company and Vice Chair of the Chicago 2016 Board of Directors. Please give a warm welcome to Ms. Valerie Jarrett.
Thank you very much.
How are you?
Fine, thank you. Well, good afternoon, everybody. Was this a week for Chicago? Let me ask you. I grew up on the south side of Chicago, again in walking distance of Washington Park, and I am so proud of our city. It has been an honor for me to be a part of the Olympic Committee, working so hard with everybody who's here to showcase to the world how wonderful our city is. We can't wait for those opening ceremonies. We can't wait for the athletes to compete. We can't wait for everybody to see what we here in Chicago already know. And when the games are over, we're going to have an incredible legacy for our city, a city that will only go stronger each and every day. So as Barack said and as the mayor said, we are proud, we are going to compete, and we are going to win these Olympic Games.
Thank you, Valerie. Next is the man who will make sure the world knows about Chicago's spectacular parks and Chicago's lakefront. He's a member of the 2016 committee and head of the Chicago Park District Board. Please welcome Mr. Gary Chico.
Welcome. How are you? Thank you. I'm doing fine. Good afternoon, everyone. Mr. Mayor, Mrs. Daley, Senator Obama, Representative Emanuel, and other dignitaries, this is obviously an exciting day for our city. We're so proud to celebrate our status as a 2016 Olympic finalist. The sheer number of you today show what enthusiasm there is to support the Chicago bid. I'm sure I speak for the entire Chicago Park District when I say just truly how excited we are at the possibility of the world being here in 2016. Our great city is able to make a credible bid because we have a wonderful park district system, which is far more than just grass and lawn. It's places where children play, where adults gather to read, relax, just plain do whatever they want. The Chicago Park District has 7,500 acres included with beaches, lakefront harbors, museums, and a whole host of world-class facilities. Chicago parks and neighborhoods are a perfect place to welcome visitors when they visit our great city, and they feel at home with all that our communities throughout the city have to offer. We want to thank Mayor Daley for his leadership and dedication to helping our great city come to this point and reach new heights on the international stage. And we very much at the Park District look forward to working in earnest with the 2016 Olympic Committee. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chico. The Olympics are the Games. It's a great city that we can host. But there's also the athletes. They're an important part of the Olympic Games. Our next speaker definitely falls in that category. She had one of the greatest careers in U.S. track and field history. She's the world record holder in the heptathlon and the American record holder in the long jump. Sports Illustrated voted her the greatest female athlete of the 20th century. Please welcome gold medal winner, Jackie Joyer Kersee.
Good try here, huh?
Hello out there, and I'm so glad to be here, and being from down the road from East St. Louis, Illinois, that all I could dream about was competing in my own city for the Olympic Games. And having 2016 here is truly a blessing. In order to do that, though, just like Senator Obama, you gotta get out there and you gotta vote. We gotta get the resources, we gotta tell people why this city is a great city and why this city would be known globally because of the diverse opportunities that are here, the diverse individuals. So it's left up to you to spread the word why 2016 should be here and will be here when we get out there and vote and make a difference. Now I sum it up by talking about why we are here. 2016, all I can do is come out and cheer. But the Paralympians and also the other Olympic hopefuls that are behind me here that you can't see, when you get an opportunity, put them umbrellas down, because athletes, we compete in rain, sleet, or snow, whatever it takes. And that's why we out here to promote 2016, because we believe in it, we believe in Chicago, and it's going to happen. Thank you.
By the way, thank you for the Blackhawks logo.
Yeah.
Wow. The New York Times called our next athlete wheelchair racing's rising star, and that's because he's established himself as one of his sport's best, having held two sprinting world records and won several major marathons, including the Chicago Marathon, three times, all while powering his wheelchair.
up to 23 miles an hour. He attended the 2004 Paralympics in Athens and plans to head to the 2008 Paralympic Games in Beijing this September as one of the U.S.'s top Paralympic medal contenders. Please give a big round of applause for Josh George. I bring this down to you.
Hey, what's up, Chicago? Now, I might not be a native of this city, but I'm definitely no stranger to this city. I went to school at the University of Illinois in Champaign, and that's where I continue to train today. Now, I love when I get to come up here and visit Chicago, and especially race in Chicago. I love the Chicago Marathon. The people of this city are fantastic. The way you're out here right now supporting this bid is amazing. The way your athletics teams are competing right now is amazing. The way you're supporting your athletic teams right now is amazing. And I love to be a part of that. Now, when I was 4 years old, I fell out of a 12-story window and I survived, and I've since become a two-time Paralympic medalist. I'll be in Beijing this summer competing in the Paralympic Games, my second Paralympic Games. And it's an honor right now to be up on stage with so much athletic talent. But it would be even more amazing to bring the Olympic Games home, to bring the Olympic Games to the United States, to Chicago, to be able to share with all of you people the excitement and the joy that comes with the Olympic and Paralympic Games. Now, let's get out there, vote for Chicago as the bidding city, and bring the games home to sweet home Chicago.
Yeah. We'd like to thank everyone for being a part of our very significant milestone today. Thank you for braving the weather as well. We'd like to thank our athletes, our para-athletes, and all of our Olympic hopefuls. But before we leave, we want to ask for your continued spirit, your enthusiasm, and your help to be able to showcase Chicago as the global city that we know it can be. There's a reason why Chicago's motto is I will, and we will continue to work towards bringing the Olympic Games here to Chicago. We conclude our program today with the raising of our new Chicago 2016 Candidate City flag. Please be safe as you leave the plaza. Take a look at our new flags as they rise to the flagpoles. Thank you for joining us. Have a great weekend, everyone. We'll be right back.